Could I have your attention, please? I've been asked to say a few words, and I think I said everything Wednesday, so, or Thursday. I'm going to have to dig out a few more. But my main point, okay, guys, our main point of this whole thing is Tinney Chapel appreciates their seniors. They appreciate their young people. Y'all have gone above and beyond in the 2 years we've been, anything we wanted to do for the children, and I consider them young adults at this church, y'all have always been willing. And we just want y'all to know today that you're part of our family, and family celebrates family, and we're just so glad. I hope we get to do this again in 4 years when you graduate college. And you know, I just expect great things. A lot of pressure on your shoulders. I expect great things out of both of y'all, because I think you're an enormous source of potential. And like I said Thursday, the people of Tinney Chapel invest in your future because we believe in you. And we consider that a privilege. So we're going to have some cake, and we're going to have some punch, and we're going to celebrate graduation again. Last time, it's overdone. College is ahead. But just know that the people of this congregation stand behind y'all, and we love y'all. And we've got your back. Y'all guys get the first piece.
Speech.
Shut up, my baby.
That's like the best punch I've ever had.
That is so cool. Is it good? Ask Miss Sherry. He said it's the best punch he's ever had.
It's Sprite.
Chocolate or what?
Ginger ale.
Hey, you got it, guys.
I have the recipe.
Go ahead.
Well, the other day I was trying to get a picture, and every time I did, this man was throwing his hand up and down. I'm just going to say, y'all go ahead.
$5
This is June the 6th. This will be this coming Saturday, correct?
Yes.
I think, wasn't Georgia kind of wanting a rough idea how many might be coming?
So, RSVP to Georgia.
Okay, RSVP to Georgia. If you got her phone number or text her or something, but just kind of let her know roughly how many. June the 7th through the 9th, annual conference is coming up. This will be in Plano. I know David and Molly will be going as our lay delegates. Men's breakfast on the 11th. 11th through the 14th is the REC weekend, where they'll be doing some training and working. On the 12th is a REC team meeting in the Life Center Native American on the 18th, Praise and Gospel Night on the 20th, and Father's Day is on the 21st. So keep that in mind. Also, this year, probably the first part of November, something like that, we're going to collect Coats for Kids again. I meant to do this last year, and the time just slipped up on me, and it was getting late in the year when I thought about it, and my mind just kind of rambles sometimes. But we're going to do that. We're going to start collecting coats now. You can bring them in on the front pew, and we'll decide where we're going to put them for the time being. We want gently used coats, nothing that you would not want your grandkids or our kids to wear to school or church or anything like that. Some gently used coats. You can go buy a new coat or two at Walmart for $20 or $30. You can make a donation.
Goodwill.
You can give the money to Jenna or Goodwill. You can give the money to Jenna or maybe Sherry, and you know, we can get together and get some coats along that way. But we'll be having some more information on this as we go. But we'll begin to disperse them about November, first week in November, something like that. But anyway, there'll be some more on that. I just wanted to remind you of that. Any other announcements, anything? I want to let you know, probably many of you know, that Sonny had a stroke Friday afternoon or evening. And Marcella called me this morning early, and they said the doctor said she had taken a turn for the worse. And Marcella said this is okay to share, that she had taken a turn for the worse and that she was not going to make it. But they told them she was going to die. They just don't know just when or how long she will hold on. So keep that family in your prayers. You know, if you want to drop a card or Carl or them, whatever, I mean, just keep them in your prayers. They'll be going through some tough times like that. So. Anything else before we move on, then we're going to have a prayer. Father, I thank you for a day that we can come together and we can realize that you are holding all of this in the palm of your hand. And Father, we pray especially this morning for Carl and Zani's family, for the kids that are there. We pray for this this part of life that they are about to experience. And we pray that you just put your peace and your comfort, just fill that family with your joy, and may they always understand and realize that you are near. And Father, we thank you for this lady that Mrs. Honey is. And we understand what the doctors say. But Father, we know that you are the physician. You're the one that's in control. And we just pray that your will would be taken care of and done. And we just pray for this family. We pray for this service as we go forth. And may we go forth now and begin to uplift and glorify your name. And Father, we just thank you for all that you do. It's in your Son's name and joy that we share. Amen.
Amen.
Well, thank Miss Pat for coming today and being with us. Molly's got some arthritis problems, and she may be out for a little while. We're not sure, so keep her in mind in your prayers. Stand with us.
His name is Wylie.
I'm not afraid to
Share? You need for prayer to lift up?
I've got a boy that had back surgery Friday, and they found some disc material in there causing all his pain. So hopefully we can drive it back for 6 months taken care of. Every time we have a celebration over there, there's always somebody that is willing to help serve punch, and she always disappears before we get the thank yous out. Alyssa?
Thank you. I forgot about that.
But she kind of disappears.
I think she's learned that.
The silent servant.
Warren's still recovering. He's doing better, but it's a little more than what he had anticipated, but he's doing well with that hip replacement. So keep them in your prayers.
My daughter Diane is having surgery Thursday for rotator cuff surgery in Dallas. Okay. Keep her in your prayers, please.
Yes, ma'am.
My neighbor across the road has passed. Linda Primer. Over a lot.
I talked to Mike Small on the phone. He had back surgery last week one day. He said he's coming around. He's doing pretty good.
Yes, sir.
Mean you'll have graduated?
That's pretty good, isn't it? Anybody else?
Well, I have something to say. We went to the award ceremony Thursday, and after we did our thing, we left. But I was talking to Hunter's grandmother last night, and she was talking about how she could not believe that we gave a $1,350 scholarship to each of these graduates. And after listening to what was given, what we heard on Thursday, y'all are extremely generous. Extremely generous, and we're just so proud.
We have not had a church this size give anything close to $1,350 a senior. That is a tremendous scholarship from church. So it's y'all have got it down. Y'all are working. Carlos.
No, thank you very much for the scholarship for the church. When in the ceremony, where the speech very nice and made me cry. when she say or both say the amount the church give to it, everybody say wow.
Yes,
yes.
It was a gas.
It's amazing.
You are so much. Tinney Chapel is setting the mark. You've set it pretty high. And that shows that young people mean a lot to you when you do something like that for them. You're investing in their future. Mm-hmm. Yes. So, do we have others?
Richard.
Jim, Brother Jim.
Brother Jim. We have a friend in Rockwall Presbyterian Hospital. He's early 30s. He has MS, but he woke up yesterday morning 2 o'clock unable to eat food. So his name is Lance Bailey, and he keeps speaking to his man.
Okay. Our next door neighbor, Courtney Lindley, suffered a diabetic coma yesterday, was taken to hospital. We think she's doing all right, haven't heard directly since then, but you know, it's pretty serious, and prayers would be in order.
We are, we went to the hospital Saturday, and we'll go back this afternoon after church, and I'm sure it'd be all right with the family. I will check to make sure, but I will try to get Jenna or Jodan one. I don't have all the talent to do that. To disperse this on our email if there's any other information, if they'll hear it. And if you are not getting any email, then it's not junk and cartoons and jokes. But if you're not getting emails from the church, give Jenna or Joe Dan your email address. And it just keeps you up to date on some things that are coming up or things that are taking place, and sometimes family issues if there's problems. So.
We also have a Tinney Chapel Facebook page.
Okay, Tinney Chapel Facebook. So you're getting ahead of me again. We're just dragging up, aren't we, Ronnie? Father, I stand amazed at you. I stand amazed and I stand just completely in awe of a God that we call upon, a God that hears our simple pleas. You've heard the prayers of your people. The one who is had a diabetic problems, the young man, I believe, up in Presbyterian Hospital in Dallas. The son who is now recovering from back surgery. Pray for the family of the one, the neighbor who had passed. Father, there's so many things that we come to you. We at times, even in our own, maybe our own bedroom, we fall upon our knees and maybe we just cry out to you. There is no other way we can turn, no other one we can turn to. Father, we know we've all tried it ourselves, but we turn to you in a desperate time of need. And Father, we pray for these that are sick, these that are hurting, the families that have passed. Pray for Carl and Zani and all that will take place there. We pray for a miraculous in her life, but Father, we pray that your will would be done. Father, we thank you for the excitement of our teens, of the young men who graduated and are stepping out. We pray for their families as this is a new transition for them too. But Father, we just thank you that we can call upon you in our joys and our hurts and our times of laughter. We thank you for this church, for the blessings that it is, for the way it shows its love to its young people. We just thank you for such an awesome church. We pray for Mike Banks and his recovery. We just lift problems and burdens to you, Father, that no one probably has even mentioned. But maybe they're just thinking of a situation in their life. Maybe it's just hard times. Maybe it's just self-doubt. But we lift these to you, Father. Thank you for the joy and the peace that you give us. Father, we just praise you for the name of Jesus who died on the cross for us. It's in your Son's precious and holy name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
I want to... Oh, let me get my glasses. Julio Cesar Olivera, would you come on up, man? And then Mama wanted Hunter's name on his Bible, and it may almost go to the back. But it's Hunter Patrick Scott Williams.
My God.
This may be the last time you're going to be in the dark in it yet. There's a little something you got to do, okay? But this may be the last time you're going to be actually in the limelight and somebody's going to do this for you at graduation again. I don't know. But I want you two guys to know how much I care for you, how much I love you as young men that have been under my ministry for just a short while. But I've grown to love you guys and to admire you guys and to respect you guys and just to see you at yourself, just your normal self. Carrying out the groceries and doing the little things for the people at Brookshire's and in school and kicking the field goals and the anticipation of where he's going and heading next and the accomplishments. Julio, I look forward to seeing what takes place in your life. I'm tickled to death with you and your family. Y'all are what I would call a godly family.
and I appreciate you very much. I thank the world of y'all. When you get the big time, don't forget who you pass to. Yeah, if you wear that out, you bring it back, we'll get you anybody. Hunter, Patrick, Scott, Williams. Don't ever forget who you are, buddy. This is a young man, I don't know if, you know, how many of you dealt deep into his mind. And I hear a lot from Mary. This is a young man who has an imagination, who can almost come up with anything and just make it work. He's a nice young man. I know he's a terrific brother. But he's a wonderful son. You know, you can tell when young people, and I don't just mean young men, but young women, you can tell when young people come from good families. They're raised and they're taught, and that is passed on down through the generations.
That's so true.
Yes, and when you hear yes sir and no sir and yes ma'am and no ma'am and, you know, thank yous and this and that, that's passed on. You don't hear kids saying that all the time now. Kids, I mean, Angela can tell you, kids that do not respect teachers, do not respect authority. But these young men, both of them, I am tickled to death with them. I look for this young man to be on the stage one of these days. Maybe in Broadway or wherever, but maybe Chicago, I don't know. Hunter's one of these guys that's going to make the best of life. And he's going to take everything that life has for him. And I'm proud of you. Thank you, buddy. As y'all walk away from here, I want you to know this church loves y'all.
Well, amen.
You are going out into this world now as witnesses, a part of Tinney Chapel, a part of Winsboro, a part of Winsboro High School, and a part of the Olivera and the Williams family.
Okay.
I feel proud. Thank y'all.
Thank you.
wanted to do. You have that in your insert. It's called You Are My All in All.
You are my strength when I am weak. You are my treasure that I seek. You are my all in all. Seeing you as a precious jewel, Lord, give up, I'd be a fool. You are my all. Fire, whatever.
but it will do what it's supposed to do. But until you hit the magic button, it's not hot, is it? It's just a wand, whatever you want to be. It's not what it's supposed to be. Do you know that's the way that we are? Sometimes we can just be the magic wand until we really discover who we are. And do you know how we discover who we are? Do you know how we discover what purpose we're supposed to have in life? How would you discover your purpose in life? Do you know? You got life way ahead of you, don't you? Any idea how you discover what you're supposed to be or what you're going to be in 20 years from now? Or any idea? Just by living? Maybe. And sometimes just by living, we may miss out on a lot, though, really, if we just accept what the world gives to us. I know he's a freshman, he'll be a sophomore coming up soon. And it's the hardest thing in the world for him to make a decision. It's hard for him to make a decision. And his mother told him, if you don't learn to make decisions for yourself, somebody else will make a decision for you. You know that? Somebody will make a decision for you.
Let me read what I sent him. I sent him, no one can make you feel without her consent.
Did you get that? No one can make you feel inferior without your consent. No one can make you feel like something not real special unless you allow them to. So, we begin to find who we are and what we're supposed to be by the things we enjoy, the things we like to do, how we express ourselves. And as we get older, those things really become opportunities then for us to really seek out who we're supposed to be. And you know who can give you the power? Be what you're supposed to be. The one who can control the switch. Is it hot? Do you know who's in control of your switch? You know who's in control? You're in control of self. But God can give you the power to be what you're supposed to be. You can be satisfied with what you want and what people tell you you're supposed to be. But if you allow God will show you what He created you for. Okay? Don't just settle. Seek God and let Him show you what He wants to change. Who wants to pray today, 3 days after, 2 days after graduation? Who wants to pray? Who wants to step up and be a leader? Anybody?
Don't volunteer somebody else.
Father, I thank you for these young people. I thank you for the time that I have with them. I thank you for the blessings that they are to us. I just thank you for the joy. Just fill them with your love. In your son's name. Thank you.
whatever I wanted you to have. But you got whatever you chose. Okay? So don't let somebody tell you what you're supposed to be. You make a choice. You choose who you are, who God wants you to be. Thank you, guys. Is there any candy people in the back? They're gone.